And we head to Jackson. Grabski coming to the plate.
Number 17, Jackson Grabski.
So can Grabski be big here in this spot? Jacksonville looking for a big base hit in the bottom of the seventh. Bases loaded. Squandered an opportunity with the bases loaded in the third. Trying not to do it again here today. Jacksonville has left six men on base so far in this one. Pitch misses high and away to Grabski for ball one. Coypel walked with one out. He's moved his way all the way around to third. Single pinch run for by Burchard is at second. Berg draws the walk. He's at first. 1-0 pitch. Grabski with a high hopper down to third base. It is a foul ball. Would have been a close play. Braid had to wait on it. Fielded it behind the bag. Would have had to throw from deep down the line to get Grabski at first. Instead, one ball, one strike. One pitch. Grabski watches a pitch float high for ball two. Jackson Grabski batting 278 on the season. The freshie. 2-1 pitch is knocked in the air down into right field. Rathbone going back on it, makes the catch, and that ends the inning. Jack time today. And we head to the eighth. It is still a five-run lead for UCF. 11-6 your score. From Van Wagner, this is the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube to stay in the loop and get exciting up-to-date news and content. That's JUDolphins.com and all Dolphins.
To stay on top of your game, it's important to take good care of yourself. And that's exactly what Baptist Primary Care doctors specialize in, helping you know the score when it comes to your health. And with more than 1,400 physicians in our network, Baptist Primary Care is your direct link to all of Baptist Health. To establish a relationship with a Baptist Primary Care doctor near you, call 202-CARE. Baptist Health, proud to be the official healthcare provider for JU Athletics.
At the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute, we are dedicated to providing you state-of-the-art rehabilitation and physical therapy designed to meet your specific needs. With an expert staff of physical and occupational therapists committed to providing individual attention, we offer comprehensive care at 10 convenient locations. JOI provides sports medicine services to professional, collegiate, and high school athletes, and also have two comprehensive spine centers, which offer massage, laser, and acupuncture therapy. We are Jacksonville's Orthopedic Institute and an official partner of the Jacksonville Dolphins.
Sam Brunig takes over on the mound for Jacksonville as we start the eighth inning, 11-6. Jacksonville tricked. Dolphins missing out on another opportunity, leaving the bases loaded for the second time today. Leading things off for UCF in the top of the eighth inning, Jordan Rathbone. He is 2-for-4 today with a Two-run home run and a bases-clearing triple. He's driven in five here today. A big day for the two-hole hitter for UCF, who has 17 driven in now this year, second on the team in RBI. Hitting 328 now on the season. Brunig, the big right-hander, making his sixth appearance of the season on the mound for Jacksonville, and the first pitch is a fastball knocked out of play to the right side. Brunig, 6 1/3 innings pitched this year, 7 hits, 6 runs all earned. The transfer from Embry-Riddle. 0-1 pitch. And a breaking ball called a strike at the top of the zone. O-2 pitch, fouled straight back. 1-2. Or excuse me, 0-2 on Rathbone. The leadoff man here for UCF in the eighth inning with the Knights leading 11-6, trying to even up this series, force a rubber match down in Orlando tomorrow with the 2 o'clock first pitch scheduled at John Uliano Ball Park. Bouncing ball down to third base off 2 hops. Grabski with a low rocket to first that skips away from Coypel. That goes down as an error on Grabski. Unable to deliver accurately to Coypel at first, and the leadoff man back on for UCF here to start the eighth. That is 6 of 8 innings now that the Knights have put the first man to the plate on base in an inning. Josh Crouch, the DH, with the runner on first and nobody out. Good secondary lead for Rathbone, and the first pitch to Crouch is lifted high and out of play to the right side. Nothing and one on Crouch, who is 0 for 4 here today. He's one of the few Knights that have really had a rough weekend. He is 0 for 8 so far in this series. O-1 pitch. Hit hard towards short, diving stop by Jalila from his knees, throws on to first and gets Crouch. What a play by Jalila to get the first out of the inning.
Catcher number 40, Ben McCabe.
Rathbone advances to second on the play. And Crouch out 6-3 for out number 1. A man in scoring position for UCF. Ben McCabe coming up 1 for 4 here this afternoon. The right-handed swinging McCabe against the right-handed throwing Brunig. First pitch, breaking ball upstairs for ball 1. Fastball in, called a ball. Looked like it was right down the middle of the plate. And McCabe ahead in the count, two balls, no strikes. Runner at second base, one out. Here in the top of the eighth inning, 11-6, UCF leading. Jacksonville a brief lead back in the bottom of the second before UCF tied it. 2-0, down in the dirt, blocked by Heffron. Breaking ball into the knees for a strike. Three balls, one strike, the count to McCabe. Rathbone down at second base with one out in the eighth. Another big opportunity here for a Jacksonville reliever. 3-1 pitch is spoiled out of play to the right side, full count. As Jacksonville is still searching for some answers in the bullpen to establish themselves as a dependable option and just to get in some solid work. Again, you come in, you're trailing on the scoreboard. Your job is to just fill up the zone and try and take care of business and see if Bruning can buckle down and get McCabe here. Payoff pitch. And he misses down and in, and a walk with one out puts runners at first and second. Double play back in effect for Jacksonville now to try and get out of the inning. Dolphins have not turned one yet today. Andrew Brait coming up 1-for-3. Single to walk, couple of runs scored. And a bunt shown and popped up straight back. Look out. Boy, that ball was that close to hitting our guy David, who's running the camera here today. And I tell you what, if we had lost a camera to a foul ball bunt attempt, I think I might have just packed up everything and gone home. A 1 pitch, and that one bounces away from Heffron, a wild pitch, and everybody moves up 90. Runners at second and third, double play out of the equation now with the wild pitch. Infield has moved in to try and prevent the additional run from coming across to score. 1-1 the count on Andrew Brait. And the pitch, a breaking ball at the knees for a strike. Brunig's 1-2. Brait right back over the head of Brunig into center field. A run comes in to score. They'll hold up the runner, McCabe at third. Rathbone scores on the RBI single past the infield in from Andrew Brait. And it is 12-6. The Knights have doubled up the Dolphins here this afternoon.
Center fielder number 5, Trent Taylor.
Runners at the corners now, still just one out here in the eighth. And that thought of a comeback, the feeling of First pitch, check swing. Did he go around? He did. It is Taylor hitting in the spot of Jostin. He came in as a pinch runner back in the seventh. Struck out in his lone at-bat in a pinch-hitting appearance last night. With runners at the corners and one out in the eighth. Brunig's 0-1. Fouled straight back. Runners at the corners, one out, 0-2 pitch, slider away, and Taylor able to lay off that one. Bright takes his lead off first, down at third is McCabe. An error, a walk, and an RBI single this inning for UCF. Swing and a miss. Taylor out on strikes. Heffron up, was ready to throw down to first, but Brait dives back in without a throw. First strike out of the ballgame for Brunig, and it's the second out of the inning here in the eighth. Connor Allen comes back to the plate. He was intentionally walked his last time up after he hit a three-run home run in the fifth, as also singled in this ballgame. Allen the lefty. The big lefty bat against the big right-hander, Sam Brunig. One ball, two strikes, and time called. Allen turns to spit in the dirt. And now he's back in as Brunig settles onto the rubber. UCF has erased the three runs that Jacksonville got back in the bottom of the fifth with two in the seventh, now one in the eighth. And a fastball for a strike on the outer edge. And you felt a little semblances of a potential comeback there. Jacksonville able to get three in the fifth, threw up a zero immediately in the sixth, came up in the bottom of the sixth, but the pitching change, the sidearmer McKay sits down the Dolphins in order. Runner goes, ground ball hit down to first, fielded by Coypel, only has to take one step to his left to force out Allen to end the inning. And that strands a pair on, but UCF get one more, and they lead by six for the second time today. It's 12-6, UCF. As we head to the bottom of the eighth, you're listening to Jacksonville University Baseball from Van Wagner, the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
Is hip or knee pain getting in the way of doing the things you love? Waiting to see the doctor could be making your condition worse. If you've had any of the five hip or knee symptoms that shouldn't be ignored, like pain or discomfort while sitting, driving, walking, exercising, or even sleeping, and haven't found relief from anti-inflammatory medicine, it's time to see the specialist at Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Our physicians offer new and innovative treatments for hip and knee pain. And the doctors at JOI are Jacksonville's most experienced at using Makoplasty, a state-of-the-art surgical technique that harnesses robotic technology for precision placement of hip and knee implants. Don't live with hip or knee pain a moment longer. Make an appointment today with a hip and knee specialist from Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Call 904-JOI-2000. That's 904-564-2000.
Pitching change for UCF as we head to the bottom of the leading 12-6 as they look to force a rubber match tomorrow. New pitcher for UCF. A lefty for the first time today, and he gets the bottom of the order here to start. Jesus Pacheco, the nine hitter, leads it off. He's 1-for-3 today. Jacksonville needs base runners in a hurry. Started off on the right foot. First pitch, fastball down and outside to Pacheco. Ball one. Patterson making his fifth appearance of the season. First time he hasn't started a game this year, but his 1-0 pitch is low for ball two. As a starting pitcher this year, he's thrown 12 innings and 4 starts, giving up 19 hits, 17 runs, 16 earned. Has struck out 14, but has walked 8. Opponents hitting 352 off of him. 2-0 pitch is high for ball three. And that partially explains why the rotation looks different here this week. Freshman who does locate a strike on the outside edge to Pacheco on a delayed strike 3 call on a 3-0 count. Hails from Vero Beach, Florida. 6'4", 190 pounds, comes home with a 3-1 and gets another strike on a ball that Pacheco is expecting to hear ball four on. And he's worked his way back in. Payoff pitch, and Pacheco strikes out swinging on a sinking fastball away.
Center fielder number 4, Ruben Sumayan.
Order turns over for his fifth plate appearance of the ball game. He has reached just one time today via a walk. Base is empty, one out. Patterson, the lefty, comes home with the first pitch, and Sumayan with a foul ball out of play to the. One pitch, breaking ball. O-2 pitch, Sumayan reaches the bat out and slaps it to the right side. This is a foot race to the bag. Patterson just gets there in time to beat Sumayan for out number 2. Nice play there as Allen combines with Patterson for 2 outs. First pitch into Corey Heffron, misses low for ball one. He is 1-for-4 here today. One 0 pitch coming into Heffron, and it's way outside. Actually glances off the mitt of McCabe and rolls back to the wall. 2-0, 2-0 to Heffron. Payoff pitch coming to Heffron. Patterson sets and fires, and it's ball four high and away. And Jacksonville's inning continues here in the bottom of the 8th, trailing 12-6 for Dakota Jalila.
Shortstop number 2, Dakota Jalila.
Jalila, for his 700th career at bat, stands in with 2 outs and a runner on first. First pitch is a breaking ball, called a strike on the outside edge to Jalila. Time called, something blue in the eye of Jalila, and he steps out rubbing his left eye now. Heffron with a short lead at first, and they throw it away. Heffron heading to second base, the ball rolling down the line. He's now digging for third base as Rathbone comes up with it and standing in at third, Heffron. He's being told to go home, but does not go home. Did the ball go out of play, or did it not? Everybody being told to hold up now. I don't know why Pattison went to first. Allen, wasn't covering the bag. Pattison threw to first like McCabe was standing there. And McCabe, who was off the bag, not holding the runner on in a six-run game, it just went sailing past his head and carried him down the right field line. And Jalila fouls off a 0-2-0-1 pitch to make it 0-2. Heffron now with throwing error on the pitcher. On that failed pickoff attempt. Ground ball to the left side. And it is backhanded in foul territory. Time called. Coach Hayes wants to have a chat with Dakota Jalila. Jalila's fouled off a couple again in this at-bat, as he has done all afternoon long. Trying to drive in a run here with Jacksonville trailing 12-6 in the bottom of the eighth. The pitch swung on and missed. Jalila down on strikes. Jacksonville strands a man at third, and we head to the ninth. 12-6, UCF leads it from Van Wagner. This is the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
If your driveway needs cleaning, your windows need washing, or your pavers need sealing, you need Crystal Clean. Don't forget your roof needs cleaning too. Crystal Clean uses soft washing, a low pressure water system with special cleaners to safely wash away contaminants without damaging delicate areas. Call 904-220-3337 or go to make your home crystal clean.
At Law Offices of George Hunter, PA, we commit to a cooperative process to get the job done to the client's ultimate satisfaction. With a client-first focus, our firm applies an extraordinary work ethic to effectively resolve legal issues. Contact us today at 813-856-2096. Law Offices of George Hunter, a proud partner of Jacksonville University Athletics.
Pitching change for Jacksonville. Jalen Hollins comes into the ball game as the freshman left-hander makes his second career appearance. He has thrown one inning so far in his Jacksonville career, allowing two hits and striking out two. The freshman from Wake Forest, North Carolina, is now throwing to Brooks Reichman, who enters the ball game to catch. 12-6, UCF leads at top of the ninth inning. The sixth pitcher used by Jacksonville today, and it all started back when Mike Casalo was forced to exit the game early due to injury, left in the top of the fourth after not retiring a batter, giving up two hits to the first two men he faced in that inning. Two innings from Tyler Nauman, an inning and two-thirds from Christian Graham, a third inning from Sam Brunig, and here is Jalen Hollins. Pablo Ruiz, the eight hitter for UCF, leads off the top of the ninth inning. 3-for-4 today. So the lefty sets to face off against the right-handed hitting Ruiz. The first pitch is hits very slowly to the left side. It is Grabski over to fielder, the edge of the infield grass, and his hard throw to first is in time to get the speedy Ruiz for out number one.
Now batting second baseman number 42.
Good pitch by Hollins there. One pitch, one out as he jams Ruiz up on that first pitch. Here is John Montez. Montez drove in a run 2 innings ago with an RBI single in the seventh. His ball put in has led to an error by Dakota Jalila. First pitch is a breaking ball that misses up and in to Montez. Lefty on lefty matchup. And he locates a fastball at the knees that time for a strike. Two balls, one strike to the nine-hole hitter, John Montez. Top of the order standing on deck. Jalen Hollins in his second career outing for Jacksonville. Lefty sets and fires and just misses a little in there. 3-1. Barring a big comeback on the bottom of the ninth, Jacksonville is set for a rubber match tomorrow with UCF down in Orlando. Fastball sprayed foul to the left side, and the count runs full. Full count, one out. And Hollins delivers. And that one is fisted off the hands to the left side and foul. Dolphins one series win so far this year. A sweep at home over Wofford. Payoff pitch. Way behind Montez, ball four. That one just got away from Hollins a little bit there, and a one-out walk gives UCF a base runner here in the top of the ninth, leading 12-6.
Shortstop number 24, Alex Freeland.
Alex Freeland, his sixth time to the plate here today. UCF with 14 hits here this afternoon. Have also drawn 5 walks here today. First pitch, a fastball right down the middle of the plate, called ball one. Jacksonville did not walk a base runner yesterday. One man reached on a free pass, a hit by pitch. 1-0, and that misses low and outside. Jacksonville has struggled at times this year with the free passes. Pitch. Locates off speed outside edge for a strike. Coming into today's game, Jacksonville had drawn 35 walks as a team while issuing 59. Also had hit 20 opponents while being hit 10 times. So that's a control thing. 2-1 pitch, runner goes. Pitches down and outside for a ball. The throw down to second is out. Good throw from Reichman. Good tag from Pacheco. And Montez thrown out, trying to steal second in a 12-6 ball game in the top of the ninth inning. Now two outs, 3-1, the count on Freeland. Three-one pitch, ball four outside. So Freeland takes the spot that Montez was just occupying down at first, but there are two outs here
right fielder number seven
in the inning. And Rathbone coming to the plate. Rathbone reached on an error his last time up. He's driven in five today. Scored in the eighth. First pitch, fastball outside. Ball one to Rathbone. And Hollins, the youngster, trying to settle down now and work on his location. He takes a little extra stroll behind the bag at first. Behind the mound, I should say. Excuse me. As Coypel holds the runner on first. Hollins sets. Comes home. And a slider misses up. Strikes the count. Two outs in the top of the ninth. UCF leading 12-6. On their way. Three outs away from forcing a rubber match tomorrow. 2-0 pitch. Fastball spiked in the dirt. Bounces away from Reichman but stays in front of him. He sheds the mask. Runs up in front of the lefty batter's box and runs it down. No chance for Freeland to advance. Hollins goes to the rosin bag. Settles back on the rubber. 3-0 pitch. And he locates at the knees for a strike. Trying to battle his way back in here against Rathbone. Now the 3-1. Outside for ball four. So Hollins has walked three in a row. A caught stealing helped eliminate one of those, but runners at first and second with two outs. And Reichman out there to have a chat with Hollins. And here comes Jalila in from short. Shout out to women's lacrosse. Second straight win over a ranked opponent. Winning 10-9. Over Virginia Tech on the road today, up in Blacksburg. A free position shot from Sarah Elms in double overtime, the difference. Four in a row for the women's lacrosse program. Fourth hat trick of the season for Elms. First pitch is a breaking ball on the outer edge for a strike. Virginia Tech ranked coming into the weekend. 18th in one poll, 16th in another. They're doing a great job so far this year beating Florida a week ago. 0-1 pitch is hit out into left field, coming in on it Burchard, and he makes the catch on the run, and that ends the inning.
For the Knights in the top of the ninth inning.
Couple of men stranded on. Jalen Hollins works the scoreless ninth. We head to the bottom half. Jacksonville's final chance, trailing 12-6. Coypel, Hunter, and Burchard due up for Jacksonville when we return. From Van Wagner, this is the Jacksonville Dolphins Sports Network.
Out here, we charge into the heartland with Mountain Dew. Out here, there's no rush hour, just the rush of flying wide open on glassy water at 5 a.m. with your first dew in hand. And there's no spin class, just bright green spinnerbait that ironically matches your second dew. Out here, we don't just play big buck hunt, we hunt actual big bucks. And out here, the best road is off-road, and the color of your truck is mud. Out here, it's dew.
Nothing beats the power and excitement of live events like Ticket Smarter. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or in the app. With every ticket transaction made at TicketSmarter.com, Ticket Smarter will donate $1 to the St. Jude Martyr. Is proud to be the official ticket resale partner of Jacksonville University Athletics. Download the app today. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets. We'll be right back. Jacksonville trailing 12-6 against UCF here on this Saturday. Game two of this three-game set this weekend, part of a four-game season series against the Knights of UCF. The second team from the state of Florida that Jacksonville has faced this season. Pinch hitter coming in the spot of Christian Coypel. It is Stephen Moffitt getting a chance to hit here in the ninth. Moffitt 2-for-15 this year, and this is ninth game he has appeared in. The right-hander hitting against the left-handed throwing Hunter Patterson, who's out for his second straight inning of work. And he locates on the outside edge with a heater to start. Strike one to Moffitt. Allowed one base runner in the eighth. That was a walk to Heffron. The 0-1. Hit on the ground to the right side, and it scoots past the diving second baseman Montez into right field. And a leadoff single for Moffitt brings up Duncan Hunter.
Duncan Hunter.
Hunter had a big hit in the fifth, a two RBI double off the wall in left as he takes a low called strike to start the at bat. 1-for-4 here today. Has a double, a triple, and three driven in here this weekend. Runner at first. They're not holding on Moffitt. Leading by on a breaking ball. Fastball high and away. No trouble laying off that one from Duncan Hunter. And the count moves to 1-2. Breaking ball that is hit hard and deep out into left center field on the run. Taylor tries to make a diving catch of the warning track, and it's off of his glove. Moffitt holding up at third. Hunter with his second double of the game. And that ball was well struck into the gap again. Duncan Hunter had one double all season coming into today. He had one extra base hit all season heading into the weekend, and he has three here in this series. Trace Burchard. Burchard getting a chance to swing it for the first time today. Fastball high for ball one. And Burchard with a high fly ball out into right field. If nothing else, it should be deep enough to score a run. All the way back to the wall, and it's misplayed by Rathbone out in right. A run comes in to score. Holding up at third is Hunter, motoring into second. Is Burchard.
Pitch hitting for Jake Berg, number 21, Kyle Richardson.
So Burchard with a double, a run comes in to score. 12-7 your score now. Jacksonville trying to make things interesting here in the ninth. You didn't add the pitcher's throw. Yeah. Kyle Richardson in a pinch hitting spot here in the 7 hole with runners at second and third. Runners at second and third. Jacksonville trailing 12-7. Nobody out in the bottom of the ninth. Richardson ahead in the count 2-0. Another fastball high, 3-0. Jackson Grabski standing on deck. A walk here would load the bases and would put the tying run on deck. Ball four high. Richardson draws a four-pitch walk. The bases are loaded with nobody out for Jackson Grabski. Well, it feels like third time should be the charm.
Third baseman number 17, Jackson Grabski.
Jacksonville has had the bases loaded twice prior today, have not scored a run. And you can circle one big spot on the score sheet if this goes again without a run scored. Pitch to Grabski, and it is in for a strike on the outside edge. Grabski today 1-for-4, singled all the way back in the second inning, which feels like it was a day ago. Hunter is at third base, Burchard at second base. Walks, and then a foul ball strike, and it makes it 0-2. If you're Jackson Grabski here, you're a freshman and win the game here with the swing of the bat. So just try and put some lumber on it and see what happens. 0-2 pitch, and he spoils it out of play to the right side. Another chance at an 0-2 pitch here. Pattison coming set, and he fires, and a ground ball hit down to second base. Fielded by Montez. On to Freeland. His relay on to first is a double play. A run comes in to score on the double play. Erasing two base runners for Jacksonville. It is now 12-8.
Second baseman number.
And the Dolphins down to their final out, still trailing by 4. Second double play that loaded here today. Both of them 4-6-3. Runner at third, two outs. Pacheco takes the first pitch outside for ball one. Pacheco today 1-for-4. He singled and drove in a run in the second inning. Pacheco trying to extend this game a little bit longer as Jacksonville's comeback effort continues here in the ninth. He takes a fastball high, and it's 2-0. Top of the order on deck. Runner at third base, Trace Burchard. 2-0 the count. Jesus Pacheco, the pitch. And he rips one out into left center field, and that falls in. Burchard comes in to score. Pacheco with an RBI single. 12-9. Pacheco with his second hit of the game, with his second run batted into the ball game.
Center fielder number 4, Ruben Samaya.
And here is the top of the order. Again, the tying run on deck.
Number
So Mayan due for a hit. Doesn't have one in this game. Has walked once. Does not have a hit since the very first at-bat of last. And a fly ball out into left field. This could end it. Going over Ruiz into foul territory, and he squeezes it in foul territory, and that does it. Jacksonville with a comeback effort in the ninth that falls short. And they fall 12-9 here today. A rubber match coming up tomorrow in Orlando as the series shifts south. That's a 2 o'clock Firth Park. We'll have the call for you here. But Jacksonville falls in game two of the series to UCF. This broadcast has been authorized under rights granted by Jacksonville University to Van Wagner. The accounts and descriptions of this broadcast may not be retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of Van Wagner and Jacksonville University Athletics. The executive producer is Ashton Golson. Special thanks to the JU Athletics Communications Office for their help. I'm Scott Manzi saying so long from John Sessions Stadium. Your final score, UCF 12, Jacksonville 9. Tune in tomorrow as Jacksonville looks for another series win. 2 o'clock first pitch from John Uliano Park. This has been a presentation of JU Athletics.
This presentation of Jacksonville University Athletics was presented by W.B. Mason, the official office supply provider of the Dolphins.